it's a good thing that moons aren't a measure of worth, because Jupiter would totally be the coolest thing floating. I mean, Pluto has 5 moons. We got one. It's one measly little moon. Hey there, lunatics. Get it? Trace here for DNews. Thanks for watching. A staple of alien worlds in science fiction is multiple moons, or suns, because we lowly Earthlings have only ever had the one moon, the creation of which is a touchy subject, actually, but you can see more on that if you subscribe and check out my video on it here. But why do we keep living moonogamously while planets like Mars get to take both of their gals for a spin? We only have one moon because of the way the solar system was formed. There are two categories of planets, terrestrial and Jovian. Terrestrial planets, Mars, Earth, Venus, and Mercury, only have 3 moons in total. Mars has 2, Phobos and Deimos, and then we have 1, the Moon, or Luna. Mercury and Venus, they're left all alone. Jovian planets, on the other hand, have scores of moons. Jupiter has more than 60. Saturn also is over that sextilunar threshold. Uranus has 27, and Neptune has 14. New Horizons is getting closer to Pluto as we speak, and imaging Pluto's 5 moons. 5. Pluto is a dwarf planet, and it's swinging with more moons than us. What the hell, Pluto? We don't know the exact reason different planets have different numbers of satellites, the technical term for a moon, but planets acquire satellites through one of 3 possible ways. 1, they get smacked by another celestial body that causes a chunk to begin to orbit. 2, they capture it using their gravity to snag a passing celestial body. Or 3, they form alongside the planet from an accretion disk. The first theory is likely how Earth got Luna up there. The second explains Mars's moons. Mars is very close to the asteroid belt that sits between the terrestrial and Jovian planets. It could have easily grabbed its protoplanet-sized satellites from there. It may also explain Pluto's 5 tiny moons. Pluto's smallest satellites, Nix and Hydra, are little icy bodies, which probably got too close and were trapped by Pluto's little gravity. The accretion disks in the third theory vogue with the idea of solar system and planetary formation. As the solar system forms, dust gathers, spinning into a disk. Eventually, gravity pulls the dust and gas together, forming a planet, while any gas floating around the edge forms planetesimals by coalescing around tiny chunks of ice or rock or flakes of metal or dust. Sometimes those planetesimals slam together, forming satellites or moons, which is probably how Jupiter got so many, for example. Venus may have had a moon at one point, but a paper from Caltech postulated the yellow planet suffered an impact, which reversed its spin, causing its moon to crash into its surface and merge with the planet. Mercury has no moon because it's tiny. And although that didn't stop Pluto or Mars, Mercury has the added difficulty of being closest to the sun. The solar wind is strong with all us terrestrial planets, blowing away material that may have formed accretion disk planets and affecting satellites more than with Jovian planets. The thing is, we only discovered other moons existed when Galileo spotted Jupiter's 4 largest in 1610. These so-called Galilean moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, lit up astronomers' collective imaginations in a fire that is still burning today. It was only in the 1970s that we finally confirmed Mercury's lack of a moon, when scientists used instruments on Mariner 10 to peek at the tiny planet. As we've learned more about our satellites in our solar system, missions have been proposed to study them more closely, and not just their giant planet parents. Parent planets. One of those. Hopefully we get to go to Europa. I've got my fingers crossed. Why do you ask? Because there might be life there. For more on that, watch this video where we actually sat down with scientists at NASA to talk to them about it.
And so a lot of what I do on a day-to-day basis is lab work, numerical modeling, instrument and mission design to try and pursue this question of whether or not there is life beyond Earth.
Thanks for tuning in to DNews, everybody. You can come find us on Facebook and Twitter. You can also come find me out there. I'm at Trace Dominguez on Twitter, and we are all at DNews.